When I built the CNC machine, I used opal plastic for these windows, and it meant that light could come into the enclosure and kind of made it a little bit atmospheric. What I want to do now is add a strip of LED lights just so the thing illuminates. I think it will look cool. Isn't going to really affect the way the thing works, to be honest. I bought a 5 meter roll of 12 volt LED tape. This is the offcut from what I used to build a tracing light box for my partner's classroom, so there's not much left. It's quite bright and the light is a cool white, and rated at about 900 lumens. It also comes back with double-sided tape, which is how I'll secure it inside the enclosure. I began by measuring up and cutting all the pieces into 5 equal sections. A small section didn't work as I accidentally stepped on it, so that part was discarded. I then tinned all the exposed end terminals and either end of the joining wires that will connect the strips together. I found holding the soldering iron with some solder suspended at its tip on the copper pads helped to transfer the solder across. And for the wires to do a similar thing with suspended solder on the tip, but pushing more solder into the wire from the opposite side. To join these pieces, you just have to hold the two tinned sections together and press your soldering iron at the right point, at which point the solder should melt and the two surfaces merge together, after which you remove the soldering iron and letting it cool. I try to keep a fan on while soldering to disperse the soldering fumes, and at some point I will build a proper extraction system for this type of work. I do have all the parts ready, but just being a little lazy. So I'm going to double up the LED strip at the front of the enclosure so it's illuminated from both sides, but I only have enough to do one side for the rest of the panels. Okay, so I'm just going to check that I've wired this all correctly. Got a feature on my soldering iron there.
If you're doing something similar, make sure you get the correct wire gauge for the application. If the flex is too thin and the amperage draw too high, this can cause the wires to heat up. There are online calculators to help you work out the correct gauge to use, and I'll link to some down below. But for the record, I'm using 24 AWG. There's a lot of stuff already in the enclosure, so I grab a pair of chopsticks to help me move, unpeel and push the LED strip into position. I work my way around the box and check the connections. I made one bad soldering joint, which I fixed. I then attached some fork crimps to the ends of the wires and screwed those onto my 12 volt power supply unit terminals. The LED strip needs a transformer that converts the AC from the mains into DC to power the lights. Now when the controller is on, the lights automatically turn on and provide a visual reminder that we're alive. The CNC machine is ready to go. The principle of installing these LEDs is the same whether you're making a light box or installing undercovered illumination, the effect of which is to make me happy. Thanks again for watching, and you'll catch me in the next one.